Did you know that apples are why colonial Americans were always kind of drunk? And that planting apple seeds won't produce the same kind of apple? You'll learn what that's all about. So much more on the history of apples in this episode of What Am I Even Eating? If you plant an apple seed, that tree produces a completely different apple than the parent fruit. Why? Apples are extremely heterozygous, which sounds like something they would ban in Florida. But really, they're kind of like people, but tastier. It means the result, whether an apple or a human, contains all the genetic possibilities of both parents. Think of it like this. You have three siblings. One looks like the mother, one looks just like the father. Maybe one is a combo of both. Okay, saying that, now I have that Prince song, When Doves Cry, playing in the background. But it's the same for apples. Apple trees have to be cross-pollinated in order to produce fruit, meaning a tree needs pollen from a completely different variety of tree. And the result is always going to be some random combination of those two parent trees. And you may ask yourself, how does this even all work? At one time, there were more than 30,000 different apple varieties, because apple trees were common across the Northern Hemisphere, with the first tree originating from an area between the Caspian and Black Sea. And as you know, now, anytime seeds make a new tree, they also make a new kind of apple, which meant a lot of regional varieties. Today, there are probably only 7,500 different varieties of apples left in the world. The Industrial Revolution was a big part of why. Fun fact, the Revolution was the name of Prince's band. Still tripping on the 80s. Anyway, science, technology, machines changed pretty much everything when it comes to how we live, even how we grow our food. The shape, size, and layout of orchards also changed dramatically, and also the number of varieties grown. The United States Department of Agriculture also formed around this time. So new orchard layouts gave way to new machinery, new equipment, but also higher yields, and varieties were selected for their commercial fitness. An orchard that once grew hundreds of different varieties was maybe now producing only 10. It was during this time that the Red Delicious became popular and pretty much changed the apple industry. Humans began domesticating apples in Central Asia around 10,000 years ago. The domesticated apple that we eat and enjoy today, the species Malus domestica, was likely bred from crab apples. Crab apples grew around the foothills in the Tian Shan Mountains of Central Asia, near a network of trade routes known as the Silk Road. Apples were traded, but also feed for the animals like the ones that pull the carts. This spread different varieties from town to town because when you gotta go, you gotta go. Just to be clear here, animals were fed crab apples from one region and pooped them out in another zip code. That's what I'm saying. So you have local crab apples and now crab apples from a whole other area. And this led, as you know, to new varieties, that whole cross-pollination thing. So when it comes to biology, there's species and then there's genus. The apples we eat today, along with crab apples and some 50 other species, are all part of the genus Malus. From species to genus to then biological family, which is Rosacea, which I'm probably totally saying wrong, but this is named after the rose, this particular family. And this family includes many edible fruits, such as the apple, cherries, strawberries, and even almonds. But apples are not berries, they're palms. Palm fruits have a central core filled with seeds. And apples weren't always just apples. Up until the 17th century, the word apple pretty much meant any fruit or nut. It was kind of a generic term. Bananas were once called the apple of paradise. Melons, cucumbers, and even pumpkins had names referencing apples. Like any fruit or vegetable or anything produced from a plant was kind of called an apple. The Silk Road is how domesticated apples made their way to Europe, and they reached as far as Ireland by 1000 BC. Apples came over to America with the pilgrims. And English settler William Blackstone planted the first domesticated apple orchard in 1629 in what is present-day Boston. Since colonial America, apples have been a very important crop, not only for food, but for the production of hard cider and applejack. Naturally fermented and low in alcohol, hard cider was safer than well water, cheaper than beer, and you can make it at home. This made hard cider an everyday beverage for most Americans during the 18th century. And in some regions, like pretty much most of the Northeast, apples were more plentiful than the grains needed to make whiskey. So enter Applejack, a homemade apple liqueur. Applejack is produced by jacking hard cider. Yeah, try not to laugh at that one. Jacked spirits are distilled not by boiling, but by freezing. With each freeze, the hard cider essentially becomes a slushy, which sounds delicious, by the way. The ice is skimmed off, therefore increasing the alcohol content of what's left behind, which was usually about 40 proof. Basically, America's first moonshine. When Jonathan Chapman, aka Johnny Appleseed, was scattering apple trees across Pennsylvania, Ohio, Indiana, Illinois, Ontario, and parts of West Virginia, it wasn't because of pie, people. Hard cider was a life-saving staple. And up until Prohibition in the 1920s, American-grown apples were less likely to be eaten and more likely to be cider. Just like the trade routes of the Silk Road, Appleseed's work led to many new varieties, around 10,000 different varieties here in America. But they weren't all for eating. They were also for hooch. And during Prohibition, apple trees and a lot of those varieties, like those that produced sour, bitter apples typically used in making cider, were chopped down. Apples first made their way to California with Spanish missionaries in the 18th century. They were a niche crop, really, until the gold rush times when orchards began to pop up to serve the growing population. California is the fifth largest apple producing state in the US, with Washington, New York, Michigan, and Pennsylvania in the lead. We also produce like over 50% of all the produce for America. The top 10 producing states also include Virginia, North Carolina, Oregon, Ohio, and Idaho. The US is the third largest producer of apples in the world after China and Turkey. But if you can't just plant the seeds of an apple to get the same apple, how are apples grown? Well, apple trees are grafted. That's when the above ground fruit producing part of a tree is joined with rootstock, the below ground part. The above ground part, called the scion, is chosen for the variety of the apple or fruit that it produces, and the below ground part is selected for its hardiness. Trees are planted when they are around 1 year old. Their second year, they begin to leaf, and by year four, the trunk is sturdy and the branches are developed. Blooms will begin and even fruit appears. By year five, the tree is mature, but the largest yields are still yet to come, usually around year six. Apple trees can produce fruit for up to 50 years. Apples are a permanent crop, and the trees are typically dormant during the winter time when they are also being pruned. March is when buds begin to emerge at the tips of the branches and tiny leaves begin to form. In April, blossoms unfurl from the buds and begin to bloom. Bees and other pollinators then get to work. By May, bloom has finished and small green fruit begins to show at the base of the flowers, with just one fruit per flower. During summer, as fruit grows, they stay green, showing their true colors closer to harvest. They go from green to light green to red or yellow. This change in color and, of course, flavor is how farmers know when the apples are ready. Here in California, July is the earliest that harvest begins, but it continues into early November and just depends on the variety and the region. Gala apples are some of the first to ripen here in California. Empire apples also ripen during the summertime. Come September, we get Honey Crisps, Macintosh, Red Delicious, and Golden Delicious. Varieties that begin to ripen in October are Rome, Granny Smith, Fuji, and Pink Lady. And Pink Lady is my personal favorite. And keep in mind, apples are hand harvested using skilled labor. They need to be carefully picked to avoid any bruising. California's top apple producing regions are El Dorado County with its famous Apple Hill. I say that because I've been going there since I was a kid. I've been visiting Apple Hill for its orchards and bake shops and so much more. And if you're in the Sacramento region, I highly recommend checking it out. Many apple orchards are also located near the coast, like Santa Cruz, Sonoma, or San Bernardino, or at higher elevations like Apple Hill, as I mentioned, but also Julian and Oak Glen. But apples also grow in the San Joaquin Valley. where pretty much everything else grows. And while apples look great in a bowl, it's the worst way to store them. Keep them in a loosely closed bag in the fridge, and I've had my apples keep this way for up to 6 months. And that's how apples got from China to California.